My name is Peter Bomsma. I'm working as a PhD candidate at the Tilburg University. And today I would like to showcase my work that I've done with, together with my colleagues, Julia Vaitonite, Mariam Alimadani, and Max Lauwersen. And in this paper, we show that the most common facial expression of humans is the neutral one. And the times that that people convey non-neutral facial expressions, it's often only containing slight activations. And this is important for IVA development because that can simplify multimodal behavior generation. The motivation of this work comes from our bigger project called Project Vibe. And the goal of this project is that we want to make avatars, create avatars to put in a hospital environment. And we have multiple partners. So the university is responsible for the brain, let's say, so for the intelligence. And we have another partner who is responsible for the embodiment. So they really create the embodiment. And they asked us, like, which facial muscles should we model? Which facial expressions are important to model? Because modeling takes a lot of time. We have artists who do that, but it's really a laborious task. So we just want to know which facial expressions we should model. So we went into the literature and we found the facial action coding system, FACS, which is probably well known by everybody. FACS is widely used to identify or to quantify facial expressions, and also to transfer those facial expressions onto an avatar. So we really dove deep into the facial action coding system, and we found out that the facial action coding system defines 46 facial muscles. And all those facial muscles can be contracted on a level from 0 to 5, so on 6 levels, 0 being neutral, and 5 being the most extreme contraction possible. So 46 to the power of 6 is this number, which is 10 billion almost, which means that the facial action coding system is, in theory, able to, you're able to express almost 10 billion different facial configurations. And of course, when we shared this with our partner said, well, yeah, I can't do anything with this. And actually also the human facial perception is very, very sensitive. If we see an artificial face, there are just little tiny differences or tiny errors in that face, then we already get in the uncanny valley. So we are very sensitive, and this combination makes it a challenge which facial expressions should be modeled and in such a way that they are very natural. And thus we came to the following question: what are the most frequent facial configurations? Because if we know what the most frequent facial expressions are, most facial configurations, then we also know which one we should model and where we should focus on. And therefore, we use 3 different data sets. The first data set is the social data set, called the Map Task Corpus, which contains 25 hours of dialogue. And this dialogue came from an experiment of the Map Task experiment, which has the goal of, there are 2 people involved, a instruction giver and instruction follower. Both have a map, and the instruction giver has a map with a root, and the instruction follower has an empty map. And in both maps are equal, but there are also some tiny differences. Thus, the goal is that the instruction follower should reproduce the root, but because there are some conflicts, communication is elicited, and such, yeah. So that's how the data set is built. Of course, everything was recorded and later on encoded by facial action coders for 11 different action units. And just to be clear, an action unit refers to a facial muscle. This data set was encoded in a binary way. So either a facial muscle was activated at a certain point, or it was neutral or not contracted. We also used an emotional data set, DISPA, which is a bit different. 27 subjects were filmed while they were watching a 4-minute video with emotion elicitation clips. And those videos were also encoded for 12 different action units. And finally, we looked at an extreme data set, which is the UNBC McMaster pain data set. Here, 25 subjects were filmed while they had to move their painful shoulder. That resulted in 200 videos, which were encoded for 13 different action units. And to be clear, the last two data sets, so DISPA and the pain data set, were all encoded for the full spectrum, so from 0 to 5. So what we then did was actually quite simple. We loaded the data sets into the software program R, and we analyzed two different things. One thing is how much are certain action units activated? So which action units are actually the most activated? And the second part was which are the most common facial configurations? And to start with the first, so which action units are most activated? We made this table. And in this table, we show how often an action unit is not activated. So if we look at the map task, for example, all the action units are 95% or more zero. So they're neutral. If we look at the DISPA dataset, you see actually the same thing. A lot of action units are neutral most often of the times. Five different action units are a bit more activated. So for example, the brow lower, which you see here, the cheek raiser, which you see here, the lip corner puller, which you see here, the lip part, and the jaw drop. And if we look at the pain data set, the more extreme data set, we see actually the same kind of thing. So it's the most of the action units are not that activated that much. The cheek raiser and the lip corner puller are activated a bit more. And then the second part of the results, we looked at the most common facial configurations. So for the social data set, the map task, we see that the neutral facial configuration occurs 88% of the time. So 88% of the time, faces are just neutral during this dialogue, followed by a facial configuration where only one action unit is activated, the outer brow raiser, and this one occurs a large 4%, and the third one where only the lip corner puller is activated, this one occurs 1.9%. The emotional data set, DISPA, it's also the most occurring one, is the neutral facial configuration. However, not as much as in the map task data set. Here it's only 37% of the time, followed by a facial configuration where only the lip corner puller is activated, and with 3%, and this one is also about 3%, actually unit 25, where the lip part is activated. And finally, for the extreme data set, we see the same. So even when people are in pain, 75% of the time they show a neutral facial expression, followed by 1.5% of the time the lip corner puller is activated, and the third one is 1% of the time where XUnit 12 lip corner pooler is also activated, and also the G-grazer. So here you see a combination of two XUnits. But in general, we saw that, especially in the Vispa dataset and in the MapTask dataset, that the top 5 or 6 facial configurations only had a single activation. So only one XUnit was activated. And furthermore, we saw that in the Vispa dataset and in the pain dataset, which were encoded for the full spectrum from 0 to 5, we saw when something was activated, it was mostly activated with 1 or 2. So slight activations, not the extreme activations with 5s and 4s. So then the question is, why is neutral most common? Well, there are different different explanations. One is that research shows that some cognitive states produce neutral facial expressions, for example, flow and boredom. Another explanation is that the MapTask dataset, the most social dataset in this research, was not really an emotional dataset. It was a very functional dataset. Functional dialogue dataset. However, even in the pain dataset, this pain dataset, which was more emotional, we still saw a lot of neutral faces. Another point is that unlike the MapTask dataset and the pain dataset, the DISPA dataset had no audience. And it is shown in the 90s already that when people are alone, they are less likely to show any facial expressions. However, albeit that DISPA didn't have any audience, we saw more wider spectrum of facial configurations in the DISPA dataset than in MapTask in the pain dataset. And also micro expressions are maybe important. Maybe the facial action coding system is not sensitive enough to really take all the different facial configurations into account, being micro expressions. Maybe that's also something to think about. So I started my presentation with this big number, almost 10 billion facial configurations that are able to be expressed by the facial action coding system. Now we can say, well, we don't need all those facial configurations. We should focus on the neutral facial expressions and slight muscle activations. And we hope that people implement this into their behavior generation systems. And that's also our future work to really include this into our avatar and to see how this works out. Thank you very much for your time and attention. Here are my contact details. Thank you very much.